Small but like also like still like solid, you know, like little porcini, known as a sep or king bolete. And this one's more like a kid bolete, but just as delicious. I bet we're gonna make some fettuccine with some white sauce, a little bit of pesto if you want. Sweet potato water to boil the pasta. Sometimes I even just keep that for like breakfast, you know, for like oatmeal, like putting it in your oatmeal. It gives the oatmeal like that sweet potato flavor. It's really, really nice. So we'll just let that boil and then do this afterwards because this goes really quick. Next, we want to cut our veggies, obviously. One thing I do want to say is that like I just got new knives. And it was the best investment I've ever made in my life. I've been using terrible knives for way too long. And it kind of just like speaks to like if you have sharp tools, like you're just able to do your job so much better, so much easier. And it's actually like, it becomes a joy to do it, you know? Cause then you're not like struggling with like a super ripe tomato or I don't know, just anything. Your tool works and you don't have to feel frustrated to make dinner or, you know, it applies not only to cooking, but, you know, like to working on your car or doing anything, really. Like, if your tools work, then, like, that's just joy, yeah. Next for the tomatoes, and we want to leave the tomatoes, like, not diced, just kind of, like, quartered. This will also go in the stir fry, but I kind of like leaving them big. Also remember to wash your vegetables before you use them, because they might have COVID. Or salmonella. Oh, and something I really like using is squash. This particular squash is called the patty pan squash, and we grow it actually ourselves over at Hilltop Urban Gardens. What's up? This is, I don't know, it's just like a really nice looking squash too, and it tastes really good. I don't see it a lot in like the supermarkets, so if you're using just like a zucchini or any other type of like summer squash, that's completely fine too. Alright, next part is the mushrooms. So sometimes it depends on the mushroom, depends on the quality of mushroom. For instance, if this mushroom, if I waited maybe like a couple more days, it might not be as fresh. And so I'd be taking off a little bit more off the outside than I would normally, but this mushroom I foraged, what was it, like 2 days ago? Yeah, like 2 days ago, so most of this is still used. I also wanted to point out that, like, I don't know, just working with food that you kind of just, like, had a different connection to or relationship with makes the dinner so much more special. Like, most of our food, like, comes from the grocery store, you know, like, it's a very, or usually it is, right? Like, I don't know how how everybody's experience is, but like it usually is pretty like a cut and dry transaction. You know, like you go find it, you pay it up, you take it to the cashier, and then you pay for it. But you know, like when you have the chance, the ability, the accessibility, you know, to find food or to, you know, sometimes even grow your own food, like the relationship that you then have with that produce, like comes back, you know, like, cause then you can see like, oh wow, this was growing on this piece of log. When I was hiking over in the woods, I remember that time. I remember who I was with, or, you know, like I'm using this tomato that I grew from my own little garden. Like I remember all the, you know, all the days that I spent watering it, you know, taking off little bugs and all the dead leaves off of it. Like it becomes a much more enriched experience, not only when you're preparing the food and cooking it, but you know, like when you're ingesting it, when you're tasting that, because you're not only tasting like the food, but you're tasting the experience that led up to you having that food.
As I awoke this morning, I had a question to ask the world. I asked, where is love? I was told love is understanding, truth and peace of mind, satisfaction of soul, and sometimes just being kind. Until by a hermit, I was told. He said, son, there's no one born of woman can tell you from self. You must go out into the world and find out for yourself.
Mushed it in, added the oat milk into the garlic and the butter, and then just the pesto. You can kind of see some of those green flakes in there, and I'm just kind of like stirring it as it's hot, kind of letting it get kind of like espesa, you know, like more beefy, I guess. So kind of just like let that sit for a minute. Next thing we want to do is we want to have like a hot skillet in which we can put our mushrooms. We're gonna put our mushrooms in first, and then we'll put in the vegetables. So you're gonna find it in your heart first. You know, in today's time,
It's hard to tell where there's love. There's so much lying, cheating, and deceiving that you can look at a friend and he'll smile and be lying. And where there is truth, there is love. Where there is love, there is truth. Where there is lies, there is nothing.
Finally, we just garnish. Garnish with a little bit of arugula. And here we have it. We have a, I don't know what to call this. Shrimp of the woods, King Bolete, sweet potato pasta. Yeah. Last thing left is just to try it, which I'll let Anna do the honors.
Yeah.